Welcome to the News Now Nation channel. Today we're talking to Mr. Vidyut Sharma and we're extremely excited to have him here today. And we are talking to him. He's one of the founders of this company called Bookchor. And we are going to talk to him about, firstly, reading habits in India, books in India, and how he is promoting the culture of reading, first of all, using physical books, but also preventing this consumerist culture of continuously buying things that aren't pre-used or pre-loved. So thank you so much for talking to us, for taking the time. And we're really excited to have a conversation with you today.
Thank you so much, Mishri, for inviting me. It's my pleasure. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Can you tell me a little bit about how the idea for Bookchor started? How it came up?
Okay. The idea came up back in 2015. Like by profession, I'm engineer. I was working as a telecom consultant before, and I was discussing with the the co-founders of Bookchor, Bhavesh. He is my brother-in-law as well. So we discussed something about the books, about. He was doing his engineering that time, actually. So we were discussing like what kind of problem he is having, how he is buying books. And so even while doing my engineering, I faced a similar kind of issue, like purchasing books. Normally, we buy used books because they are quite affordable. Mm-hmm. And books are something which you can reuse easily. Like there is nothing, you just need to go for the new one only. That is the base. That was the base, like where we started off this company. We thought, okay, let's have something online because that time it was not existing actually. So we thought, okay, it's the need of the hour and we can do something about it. So from there we started off and now we are here.
Awesome. I think it's so important. And even, you know, as a student, college student myself, the books are so expensive to buy firsthand. And you're right, they're the easiest commodity to reuse. They're the easiest commodity to pass on. And it's really incredible. But now I see the website has a lot of even like fictional books and a lot of, there are multiple categories of books. So after this initial idea, how did it materialize into what it is today?
Okay, while going through the market research, while going shop by shop, actually we found, okay, there is a need for the textbooks and there is a bigger need for the general trade books also. Because as such, during that time, there were no shops and the reading culture was degrading day by day because of the non-availability of books. But then we found, okay, yes, there are a couple of areas where they are readily available in India also, but they are limited to metropolitan cities like Delhi, like Mumbai, or maybe Chennai, Kolkata. So these areas, they have these kind of culture, they have these kind of shops where you can go and buy general trade books. I'm talking about the novels and fiction, non-fiction, these kind of books. But as such, in smaller cities or in other part of country, it was not available. And to my surprise, it was not, like in Haryana especially, people were not finding it good also for their kids to read general trade books. Although now the culture is evolving, I can see the industry is growing very fast. People are like, they are very curious and they are trying their kids to read books as much as they can, because it is the basis of their education. Actually, it should not be only textbooks they get education, but the readership or the reading habits is these are also very important. They understood now.
Yeah, absolutely. The reading habit is a really integral part of students and just people in general. It's great for your mental health. It's great to expand, you know, your horizons of thinking. But the reading culture is objectively dying. I can personally say I have seen the reading culture die in myself, because when I was younger, I used to get books and, you know, birthday gift par bhi book milta tha. And it was very, very exciting for me. And I used to love reading. And ever since I got Netflix and I got Amazon Prime and I got access to the internet and I got a phone. The habit for reading declined. So how do you create a space in an industry that is in a habit, in a culture that in which reading is dying? How do you create a business space there?
Okay, see, what I believe, this is my opinion and this is my experience. Reading culture is evolving in India. It is not dying, okay? Because we have seen the growth in the industry. And before and now, there is a huge growth. Even we are on the panel of Nielsen, which is providing all the reports about the market research and everything. Second, what I believe, like before, the books were quite expensive. And so the new books are still very expensive. So how we are helping readers? Because when you see books on BookChore, we are giving books at a very, very affordable price. For example, 100 rupees or less than 100 or 150. Yeah. Which might, like, the new book might cost them 450 or 400 rupees easily. So the first step we took was to provide them affordable books.
Correct.
Second, there is a mindset in India for used product, especially. Yeah. The mindset says that definitely it is going to be scrap material, so don't go for it. So we changed that completely by introducing a quality check mechanism in used books also. So we were the first company in India who promised all the readers, like, there will not be any missing page. If there is a slight damage, so we introduce the quality of books. Like, on BookChore, you will find almost new condition book or good condition book or readable condition book, where the readable condition is also the condition where people can read it quite comfortably. So whatever books where we find book pages are missing or it is not readable, so we just send them to the recycler. So this is how we are maintaining the quality also. Now people are getting confidence also on used books as well.
Yeah.
So I think that is working very well for us.
I think that is incredibly important. And affordability, yes, it was, becoming a hindrance. Because why buy a book online? Why buy a physical book for 400 rupees when you can entertain yourself, in so many other ways? Another thing I think that is really important that BookChore is doing is creating this, creating a mindset shift towards being able to use pre-owned material. And I think it was something that was kind of looked down upon. It was something that was kind of considered ki, hum log to second hand nahi kharite. Second hand is the word that is, used.
Right.
And I think right now we are talking so much about how, like, carbon footprint and each one, how much waste we are leaving behind. And to everybody who is watching this, if you, instead of buying new books, start buying, pre-owned books that are in readable condition, as you said, that are quality assessed. If you buy pre-owned books, that makes a huge difference to your carbon footprint rather than buying a new book. So I think that is an extremely important thing you're doing. What we haven't done is that I know what BookChore is because it's a very, very famous company, and I'm sure a lot of people do as well. But for the people who don't, if you could just introduce a little bit about the company and how it works.
Okay, BookChore is a company which is into pre-owned as well as new books. Although we are into new books, why? Because there are new releases also. We need to introduce those kind of books also to our customers. And we are into pre-owned, so that, I'm so sorry.
Hello. Don't worry.
Can I ask her?
Of course, you can.
Actually, she's here because today is off for the school. Mm. So I'm so sorry. You can
don't worry about it at
okay.
all.
So the thing is, we started off like in 2015. So with the aim to inculcate reading habits among Indians. This was the aim. Our aim was not to make $1 million out of it. It was not the aim. So just to inculcate. So we started off these general trade books so that people start reading. I spend a lot of time out of India and I found it very interesting. Like overseas people read a lot. That's why when you communicate with them, their communication sense, their understanding of things is totally different than if the person is not reading.
Absolutely.
Like I'm not talking about like a country-wise thing, but this is the basis. So this is how we started, and for affordability, we started this bookshop.com where you can buy books for a toddler to any age. And then we introduced one more concept, which is called Lock the Box. So it was a quite new concept where we made books more affordable. Mm-hmm. How this is working, like there are three sizes available. So you need to choose one size of the box. And you can fill it as many as with as many as books you want.
Wow.
So you just need to pay one time for that box. So whatever books you are buying and whatever books are fitting into that box, that is paid with that one time payment.
You pay by volume, not by like,
yes, volume. So you don't need to worry. You don't need to worry about market price or the print price of the book at all. No discount structure, nothing. So you know that you are going to pay maybe 1200 rupees. And these are the books you are going to buy with that kind of money. And there are three sizes, like 1200, 1800 and 3000 rupees. It was offline event, basically city level. So we did it in about 22 cities. We had this Lock the Box.
Wow.
And we got amazing response. There are hundreds and hundreds of videos on YouTube, which were prepared by our readers only, and they are so much happy about it. But unfortunately, this pandemic came, and the whole thing went down. And then the readers started asking us, when you are going to start? Kab shuru hoga ye fir se? Lock the books kab ho raha hai? But you know, we need to comply with the government guidelines.
Absolutely.
So what we thought, we will introduce the offline venture to online. Hmm. Now we did Lock the Box thing online as well.
Wow.
So it is working absolutely the same way how it was working offline. The only difference, like you don't need to touch the books. Like you just need to browse it through app and you fill it in a box and then pay one time. So it is working.
Brilliant.
Very well. So,
brilliant. That is an extremely cool thing. And I think right after we finish this call, I'm going to go check that out myself. Because I would love to get a box for a book.
West Bengal. Sorry?
In West Bengal. You're going to have an offline sale?
No, online sale.
Online sale.
So it is a state-wise sale.
Yeah, all
it
right.
It is like Pan India, you can have it.
All
because,
right.
Because of the operational issues.
Mm.
Because this is a big sale.
Correct.
Every day we are selling about 8,000 to 10,000 books.
Wow.
In Lock the Box. So operational challenges are there. Even we don't want it to be a regular thing. It has to be
a special. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. It has to be something that people look forward to. And how can somebody stay updated and know when the next Lock the Box event is happening in their state?
Okay, so we are available, like very active on Instagram, Facebook, and we are having this website called lockthebox.in. So they can go and get the things updated over, like get them updated.
All right, absolutely. And it's an extremely interesting concept, and it really makes you want to, you know, touch and feel books again. I think in the lockdown, the need to read has increased because, you know, you're looking at a screen for work, you're looking at the screen in your free time because, you know, you're watching Netflix, you're looking at the screen when you want to socialize also, because even your family, sometimes you have to meet them over FaceTime or Zoom instead of actually meeting them in real life. So I think it's incredibly important that we develop some habits and we create some slots in our day at least, where we're not looking at a screen and we are looking at papers and pens and doing hobbies and, you know, staying away from technology. I mean, at least for me, I feel like I'll go mad if I keep looking at the screen for 24 hours a day.
You should read sometime.
Yeah. No, you're right. And I think this lockdown had a huge role to play. The pandemic, you know, of course, it did affect bookstores and it did affect, every industry across the country, but specifically the entertainment and the value for arts and the value for content has increased a lot, because we realize that, you know, at the end of the day, these are the things that keep us going when we are locked down in a house.
Yeah. You see, you know, this lockdown taught us a new thing also. Now, even new parents, like those who have toddler or kids with the age of 1 to 3 or 1 to 5, they want their kids to read more.
Yeah.
Because they understand that the whole time their kids are on mobile phones. Even the classes are on mobile. So even they are helpless because the classes are online. So their kids are having this habit of browsing things, or browsing YouTube all the time. So now we are getting lots of inquiries related to children books. And that industry is also going very well. So very soon, Bookchore is going to launch a new product for kids.
Wow. Brilliant. I think there are so many exciting things coming up. But just to recap, so that none of our viewers forget anything that we have mentioned, they have Lock the Box sales, which are basically where books are sold by volume and by weight instead of, you know, just sabziyan khareedte hain. Waise people get to buy books and you get to buy books in bulk and introduce this a lot of new content into your home. They also have something coming up for kids, which is very exciting. And hopefully now, as the pandemic slows down and hopefully things get better, we hope to see Bookchore in a lot of offline forms also. Do we?
Definitely, yes.
That is extremely exciting. Anything else you would like to add as we, you know, move towards the conclusion of this interview? Anything else you want to tell people about reading, about if people, you know, I would say for people who have lost the habit of reading, how do you tell them that, you know, start just...
I think they need to take the decision immediately. And believe me, reading is the best thing they can do with their life. This is the best possible thing. They don't need anything else. Like, once you start reading, you will be into entirely new world.
Absolutely.
Like, whether it is fiction or non-fiction, it is up to you.
It is up to you.
So I think everyone should read at least half an hour. Like, they can start reading half an hour in a day, or maybe 15 minutes in a day.
Yeah.
And they will see the change in their life.
Absolutely. I agree with you. For me, I will always associate reading with, being on a vacation. And because that's when you don't want to look at your laptop, you know, no chance. I don't want to see my laptop when I don't not carry it. And, you know, you're just like reading a book all day. And it's really the best feeling. It transports you to another world completely.
Yes.
And it is incredibly cool that in India we have such a cool mechanism for this transfer, and I'm so, you know, it makes me so proud to hear that there are companies like Bookchore inculcating this system of transfer of knowledge, transfer of books within the country. So thank you so much for doing what you do and having this incredible purpose in mind. And I would encourage everybody to whenever you are buying books, to first look at your local bookstores, to look at companies that are Indian, to look at companies that are, working on pre-owned books, seeing if there is pre-owned, because you owe it to the world, you owe it to, you know, live a more carbon efficient lifestyle, to live a more sustainable lifestyle. And Bookchore is doing a lot to promote that while promoting the incredible habit of reading. So, which is why I really, really encourage everybody to check out the app and first look whether the book is available in a pre-owned condition online. And if not, then consider buying a new version, right?
Right.
Absolutely. All right. Thank you so much for talking to us. We had a great time talking to you. We had a great time learning about your company and whatever it's doing. This has been great. Thank you so much. We hope everybody who watches this enjoyed and gets a little push to get back on their reading habit.
Thank you so much for your time.
All right.
Thank you.